Thank you, President, President Daggett, Vice President, Executive Vice President Daggett, and Vice President Steve. Brothers and sisters, first, I want to tell you that for me it's a very special day to be here. I will explain you later why, but it's not because I dress a tie, because it's the second time in my life that I dress a tie. I can assure you that I'm not the best comfortable to be with a tie, but I promise Dennis 4 years ago in Puerto Rico that I will dress a tie in the next convention, and I am trying to look at good, but I am so comfortable with the tie. But I'm look a movie star, no? I look. It's a great honor to be here at the 55th quadrennial convention of the ILA and to be able to address all of you. As general coordinator of the IDC and on behalf of about 130,000 dog workers around the world in Africa, Asia, South America, Australia and Europe, I want to bring a message of recognition. The IDC values the role of the ILA over the history, defending all the longshoremen. You are, without any doubt, the great reference for dockers around the world. Our organization, the IDC, it's an association of port organizations around the globe. It's an organization of working class workers, politically and economically independent, democratic, and assembly based. We are, as I told you before, an organization that we are growing up. 4 years ago in Puerto Rico, we were 64,000 longshoremen affiliated to IDC, and today we can tell you that we are close to 130 longshoremen. And all of that with a simple organization, a dynamic organization, and effective, where our great power is the unity. I wanted to make all of you a small reflection. If the port companies are creating big holding companies to be stronger, the shipping lines are creating big alliances to be stronger, governments create alliances with the and legislations to be stronger and to be powerful against us. And we, what we are doing is created this movement to become the most powerful maritime union of the planet, to secure our future, where we can demonstrate, as we have already, that if they attack one, they attack all. And I want to take the opportunity to say hello to my brothers of the ILWU, led by the President Adams, my brother Bobby and Ed Ferris, and all the delegation. This means unity. The state is united, and this is a good message to APM. We have very great challenges, but my speech will be short and will be around 3 great issues: automation, solidarity, and the commitment. The truth is that we have a lot of challenges around the world. First, for me, the most important is the health and safety. Every accident, every brother that don't return to his house, to his family, is a big defeat for everybody. Our objective is the accident, zero accident in the port. And for this, the employers must to invest in good machines and in good invest in training. We have challenges with the non-union terminals, challenges in our jurisdiction, political attacks on labor, policy deregulation, competition between ports, union busting, persecution, repression, all of this is happening around the world. But now, the most common attack we have these days is the automation. I want to let clear which is the IDC position. The IDC position is the same than the ILA. We are radically against the technologies that are used to replace the task of the jobs. I think it's very clear. We want a job, a fight. Why we can negotiate automation? We can negotiate to lose jobs or tasks. It's impossible. We have to fight. We don't negotiate. How could I look to my kids, to your kids, to our people, to young people, and tell them that we lost our task because we changed for good pensions, for good money? I will be dead. and I'm sure that all of you will be in the same line. No, friends, what you have done in the master contract has been the seal of our future. And for this reason, I want to thank you, Harold, Dennis, and the whole ILA, to reach this agreement that for me is and will be the Bible of the dog workers around the world. And in fact, already in conversations with the European Seaports Organization, the European employers, I have proposed the same model that the ILA has signed in this contract. No automation, just to the productivity. We have demonstrated around the world that we are more productive, more efficient, and more profitable than robots. And we have demonstrated. So fuck automation. The second topic that I told you that I want to talk is about solidarity. I think that is the most beautiful word that you, the English people, has. And for me, it's difficult to talk in English. Yeah, I suppose you know. I most recognize the important role that the ILA is playing for the development of the African and Latin America, South American dog workers. I just need to know two guys that it's Ken Raleigh, the vice president, and Mark Bass from Alabama, who never has a no for all those travels or those trips, which are not very pleasant, very easy to visit. And they act with a loyal and with committed exemplary attitude with ILA and with the IDC. I want to put an example that happens a couple of weeks ago. We went to Cameroon. I suppose not so many people will have gone to Cameroon the last 2 weeks. Where the government's advice not that we should not go there because there are terrorist attacks to the people from Occident, from the States, from Europe. The Spanish government told me, you have not to go, you are not protected. The American guys also told to Kenny and Mark not to go. To the French government, say the same. But we cannot let them alone. We had 1,500 dog workers on the hire, and we decide to go, to fight, and to try to win. As you can imagine, in the meeting, same companies, same shipping lines that comes here, the call goes to Europe, and the big problem was the high salaries of the dog workers. The salary, in fact, now of the dog workers are $12 for 12 hours of work. And this is a high salary for the same fucking companies that are negotiating with us. And they are proposing us, they were proposing us $3 for 12 hours of work. It's incredible. The same companies, the same ships, the same work, and they are trying to attack our most weak part of the union. And we will answer. We have a project to answer. We are preparing a campaign to support them. But it's amazing, amazing what we see around the world. For this reason, I ask you to join our side, to join my side, to join our side. You are going to suffer. You are going to cry. You are going to wear yourselves out, including you are even going to vomit. But together, united, we are going to have the capacity to change the world. And maybe this click all together is the necessary, and we open a new cycle where the toxic people stop reigning in this world, and the common sense, the dignity, the friendship, and the solidarity reign. I'm sure that if we are united, it's impossible to fail. The third topic that I told you is the compromise between the IDC and the ILA. First, I want to thank you for the fantastic support on the Spanish conflict. It was amazing. I will never forget the moment in Al Jazeera where we were going down from the hotel to the assembly place where thousands and thousands of people were waiting us, Virgil, Dennis, my friend Marco, the Australian guys, the guys from ILWU, and thousands of people were waiting us shouting, ni un paso atrás. Dennis thought that they were saying USA, but we were saying, no one step back. But his Spanish is not very good yet. This day, I think that was the best day of my life as a general coordinator, was the day where we changed the Spanish decision of hiring all the dog workers to out. And I will never forget the extremely support that they give to us. The other big conflict we had in the last few months has been in Sweden, as President Daggett and Dennis talk about. I recognize you that after meetings and months of fighting, I was really desperate for the dismissals, for the threats, for the situation that the Swedish families was happening there. I prepared a meeting in my house, in my hometown in Barcelona, where I called to the big unions of IDC to come and to take a decision. If we allow that the APM win to the Swedish union, we will happen the same that happens in Liverpool 20 years ago. The ILA delegation led by Harold and Dennis, with my brother Virgil, with John, with Pete, with Mike, Kenny, Mark, Stephanie, they were a very special gang of guys from the ILA. They call me son of a bitch. They think that it's very wonderful for me it's called son of a bitch, but they demonstrate that together we are a very strong son of a bitch. In the meeting, we decide to go to win. We win, and we don't let to happen again what happens in Liverpool again. Was similar actors. The companies sack people. The union, the other union, agree with the company. Same actors, same situation. But in this case, we had a big organization of the workers, the IDC, with the big support of ILA, with the support of IWU, of the European unions, Australian unions, African unions, South America, all together to fight. And we got it. After 47 years of history, the Docker unions get his first CBA. Finally, my body asked me to do a special recognition. As is told this morning, 7 years ago, I remember very well the restaurant in Manhattan where we met together, Harold, Dennis, Antolin, myself, and Kenny, in a restaurant in Manhattan. You can imagine the meeting. I was very impressed by President Harold. Before going to the meeting, we prepared during 4, 5, 6 hours the meeting. We have to explain that about how is IDC, which is the project, the future. The truth is that the first sentence that Harold say, hey guys, we want to affiliate the entire ILA. We want to talk to IDC. Come to begin to talk of the long chairman. I say, hey, wait. We have been preparing the meeting for hours. I say, no, the affiliation is done. We have to continue. I say, hey, my man. And we decide the affiliation of IDC. And was the best, and the was the best thing that happens in all my life. The truth is that we were talking all the night about the dockers, about longshoremen, about the future, about the new issues that we have on front, like automation. And next to me, it was sit a guy I didn't know. I only just know this day that was called Dennis. I didn't know it was the son of Harold. We will be talking about everything. He impressed me for his vision, his energy, and his wisdom. And what he told this morning, that was crazy that one guy born in New Jersey, one guy born in Barcelona, we have a lot of things in common. We begin a very strong and unbreakable friendship. Sharing strategies, sharing confidence, sharing tactics, include, I don't know how many times I've been in the house of anybody, but I went to his house a couple of or 3 months ago to Sparta. It's the coldest place of the world for running. So I wake up at 6, 7 a.m. to run like every morning. I just think, I thought I was in the north of Canada. It was crazy, the cold that it was happened there. But his family is wonderful, very beautiful family, and he makes me feel like at home. And for me, it's special because personally, it's a reference, it's an inspiration, and not only just a union leader, but as father, as a son, as a brother, as a friend, as a comrade. And I'm very excited to be considered friend of my brother Dennis. For me, it's a pleasure, and I love you. I love you the more that I can tell you, man. Okay, last thing. I start my intervention telling you that today was a special day for me. I bring a lot of years of union leadership. I continue working on my port. I used to be crane driver, teleman, so I continue driving cranes, being foreman now from 7 years ago. But in all these years that I have been in union duties, the truth is that my family have seen me just on the TV or in the newspapers. I never let them come to an assembly, to a convention, to see what's going on in your meetings. Today I want to be different because I feel like at home. I am happy with you. I feel like as a part of this fantastic family that is the ILA. And for this, I ask them to come here to see what is my family of the United States, of the East Coast of the United States, and knew all of you. For this reason, I will ask my kids, and with the help of Mark Bass and Ken Raleigh, to deliver a special gift to President Daggett and Executive Vice President Daggett. Please, can you? Hey, chicos. They don't speak English. They speak French, Catalan, Spanish, but not English. So it's this symbol is come. No, por aquí, por detrás, por detrás. Wait. Could you stand, please, Dennis and Harold, please? Y por detrás, por detrás, por detrás, por detrás.
It's beautiful.
It will.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my God. Come here. Let me pick you up.
Okay, the eagle, President. The eagle is the symbol of the power, and is presented to the President Daggett and Executive Vice President Dennis, and the whole ILA for your incredible vision, strength, and leadership in protecting the future of the dog workers of the world. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you, Jordi. Give your daddy.